Hello everyone, how are you? Hope you are doing very well. Welcome to our English class. Today we will learn about spelling word sort. So it will include full Y, O-U-S, L-Y, and E-R. Today we will cover page 117, 120, and 126 from your journey, which is your small book. So if you are ready, let's start it. Right now, first of all, please open page 120 from your journey, which is your small book. Okay, when you open this page, you can see three categories to categorize the words. First category is words that end with the suffix full. The other one is words that end with the suffix ly. The last one is words that end with the suffix er. So how can you categorize it? Let's check the basic words. Let's start with the first one, singer. First of all, suffix represent the last words. If there are two last words here, I need to check it for last two letters. So, singer, er and er here. So, for singer, I need to put it to the words that end with the suffix er. What about loudly? For this category, for the second category, I need to check the last two letters, L-Y, loudly. So, loudly is appropriate for the second category. What about third, joyful? For the first category, I need to check it for the last three letters, joyful. So, joyful is for the first category. You can fill the rest of it by yourself and you can check your answer with this video. Okay, let's continue. Teacher. Check last two letters. So it's for words that end with the suffix er. What about fighter? Fighter is also will be in the same category with teacher. Good. What about closely? L-Y. So, I need to write it for the second category. And seventh word, powerful. Full. So, I need to write it for the first category. Farmer. What about farmer? Good job. So, I need to write farmer for the third category. Quickly. Quickly. So, I need to write quickly for the second category, which is words that end with the suffix ly. What about careful? Careful. I need to write careful for the first category, which is words that end with the suffix full. Good. What about friendly? Friendly. I need to write it for the second category. Good job. What about speaker? Speaker. I need to write speaker for the last category, for my third category, which is words that end with the suffix er. What about wonderful? Wonderful is for the first category, because it's finished with full. What about truly? Truly is finished with ly. In this situation, I need to write it for the second category. Right now, let's check the review part. It says, add the review words to your word sort. So, let's check it. Hopeful. It's finished with full. In this situation, hopeful is appropriate for the first category. And then, safely. Safely. It's finished with ly. In this situation, it's appropriate for the second category, which is words that end with the suffix ly. Then, let's check challenge. Add the challenge words to your word sort. Let's check them. Listener. Listener. It's finished with ER. In this situation, it's appropriate for the last category, which is words that end with the suffix ER, because it's finished with ER. Calmly. Calmly. It's finished with LY. In this situation, I need to write it for the second category, which is words that end with the suffix ly. Good job! If you finish, let's check page 117 from your journey, which is your small book. Right now it say read each sentence, choose the missing word from the box, this is box, and write the word, then read it to complete sentence. Okay, let's read the first sentence together. On a day, I have to hold on to my head. Which day? Which is appropriate for the first gap? On a windy day, I have to hold onto my head. Good job. What about second sentence? The first of soup is the hottest. The first of soup. The first spoonful of soup, right? Good. What about third sentence? The dancer leaped across the stage. The joyous dancer leaped across the stage. Good job. What about fourth sentence? Damien walked across the swinging bridge. So he needs to be brave, right? In this situation, what are you right here? Damien bravely walk across the swinging bridge. Good job. So what about fifth? The planted flowers that would attract bees and butterflies. The what? The gardener planted flowers that would attract bees and butterflies. Okay, if you finish until here, right now we will check six sentences. Let's check it. The lamb followed behind its mother so it wouldn't get lost. If you follow something, if you follow someone, you will be so close, right? So it will be the lamb followed behind its mother so it wouldn't get lost. What about seventh sentence? My dog spilled her food and tracked mud across the floor. My messy dog, right? My messy dog spilled her food and tracked mud across the floor. Okay, next sentence. It was a occasion at my house when I brought home a good report card. So, which one is should be appropriate for this gap? A graceful occasion at my house, because when I brought home a good report card, it's a good report card, so it will be a graceful occasion. What about next sentence? Do you feel about singing the solo in the school play? If you sing by yourself, do you feel nervous about singing the solo in the school play? What about last sentence? Wanda crossed the finish line, she held her hands over her head in celebration. Wanda, who is running? The runner. So when the runner crossed the finish line, she held her hands over her head in celebration. Good job. Okay, right now let's check page 126 from your journey, which is your small book. It say, write a basic word to complete each sentence. A person singing in a choir is a... If you sing something, you will be a singer, right? Good job. What about second sentence? If your friends yell during a game, they are playing. If you yell all the time, it will be so loudly, right? So they are playing loudly. Okay. What about third sentence? A person who grows corn in the country is a... If you grow something, if you live in a village, so you will be a farmer. A person who grows corn in the country is a farmer. Good job. What about fourth sentence? If you run fast, You are moving quickly. If you run really fast, you are moving quickly. Quickly will be the appropriate for this gap. What about fifth sentence? If you are really happy, you are, of course, joyful. Joyful will be the most appropriate word for this gap. Okay, if you finish until here, let's check sixth sentence. It says, the person whose desk is in the front of your classroom is your... Okay, who am I in the classroom? Your teacher. Good job. Okay, next sentence. Someone who is very strong is powerful. If you are really strong, you will be also powerful. Good. What about eighth sentence? When you use scissors, you should be careful not to cut anywhere, okay? You should be careful. What about ninth sentence? A person who smiles and asks you how you are feeling is friendly, right? If you always smile and if you ask how you are feeling is, you are friendly. Good job. What about last sentence? If you are sorry, you will make a sincere apology. If you are truly sorry, if you are really sorry, you will make a sincere apology. Good job. Okay. Thank you so much. Take care of you.